Here, first we will see the definition of the counter. Counter is an sequential circuit capable of counting the number of clock pulses arriving at its clock input. And a counter is a set of flip-flops whose states change in response to pulses applied at the input to the counter circuit. Now, the counter circuits are divided into two categories. Firstly, asynchronous counter, and second one is synchronous counters. First we will see asynchronous counters. The asynchronous counters, we may also call it as ripple counters. Now here, this is the logic diagram of 4-bit binary ripple counter. Here, this binary ripple counter is a series connection of complementing type of flip-flops. Complementing type of flip-flops means either we may consider JK type flip-flops or we may consider T type flip-flops. Now, by seeing this logic diagram, here the first flip-flop having inputs J, they are inputs, and the clock pulse from the outside. So here, for the first flip-flop only, we are going to provide the clock pulse from the outside. And the second, third, fourth, these all successive flip-flops can be triggered by the previous output of the flip-flop. The second flip-flop can be triggered by the output of the first JK type flip-flop. And the third flip-flop can be triggered by the output of the second flip-flop. The fourth flip-flop can be triggered by the output of the third flip-flop. Now here, firstly, we will clear the all the flip-flop outputs. So, initially, the outputs of these four flip-flops, bits we may consider it as 0, 0, 0 and 0. Always, in the ripple counter circuit, the clock pulse given flip-flop output must be least significant bit. The clock pulse given flip-flop output bit must be LSB bit. So here A1 is the LSB bit and the last flip-flop, here it is A4 bit, indicating A4 bit. This bit is going to be the most significant bit. So here the rightmost bit will be the LSB and the leftmost bit will be the MSB bit. Now we will see the circuit operation of this 4-bit binary ripple counter. In any ripple counter circuit, how many number of binary bits we are handling, it will decide the number of flip-flops should be used. In this circuit, it consists of 4 binary bits. So we have to use 4 number of flip-flops. Here I am using 4 JK flip-flops. So, in this circuit diagram, all the flip-flops JK inputs are at logic 1 state. In the JK flip-flop truth table, here already we learned that when JK inputs are at 1-1, the next state Q of T plus 1, that means after giving the clock pulse, whatever the input we may get, it is going to be the Q of T plus 1. That is going to be complementary of Q of T. So, when the present state before giving the clock pulse output is equal to 1, the next state Q of T plus 1 is going to be complement of this bit. It is going to be 0. Or when Q of t before giving the clock pulse bit is 0, the Q of t plus 1 after giving the clock pulse, next state output is going to be complement of this bit is going to be 1. Based on this logic, J equal to 1, K equal to 1, we are going to find the bits A1, A2, A3, A4. And if we see here, the first flip-flop clock pulse is having a small circle here. It is indicating that this is a negative edge triggering flip-flop. Means when there is a transition from 1 to 0, this flip-flop is going to be turned on. Here the second, third, fourth flip-flops are also indicating that they are negative edge triggering flip-flops. Means when there is a transition from 1 to 0, then only that flip-flop is going to be triggered. It will be in the same state before giving the clock pulse. Now we will apply the first clock pulse at this stage. So when the clock pulse have a transition from 1 to 0 and the first flip-flop JK inputs are at logic 1, this flip-flop is going to be triggered on. So the output after applying clock pulse, the output of this first flip-flop is going to be the complement of before giving the clock pulse output. So here before giving the clock pulse output for the first flip-flop is 0. So after giving the clock pulse, this output will become 1 here. To turn on the second flip-flop, we need a 1 to 0 transition. But here 0 to 1 transition. So this second flip-flop is not going to trigger. So it will be in the same stage. So this output is going to be 0. So second flip-flop is not triggered, means third flip-flop is also in same stage. It will be equal to 0. It is also not going to trigger. And fourth is also not going to trigger. Next, after giving the second clock pulse, this first flip-flop is going to be turned on and JK are at 1, logic 1 state. The before giving clock pulse output is 1 here, means complement of this bit is going to be 0. Here we get the transition from 1 to 0, which will turn on this second flip-flop. So the second flip-flop output is going to be the 0 complement 1 here. But to trigger on this third flip-flop, again we required a 1 to 0 transition. But here it is giving the transition from 0 to 1. So this third and fourth flip-flops will not going to trigger. So this will be in remain same stage. Again applying the third clock pulse here, this 0 complement will become 1. And to trigger on the second, third, fourth flip-flops, we need a 1 to 0 transition. So it will not going to trigger on for 0 to 1 transition. These will remain previous stage before giving the clock pulse. So in this manner, we will find all these transitions. In this similar manner, when we are applying clock pulses, these are the different count sequences we may found. Here, at this stage, when we apply a clock pulse to this first flip-flop, it will going to turn on, which will give the A1 bit complement of this one. 1 complement will give 0 here. And transition from 1 to 0, which will turn on the second flip-flop, and it is going to give the 0 complement will going to 1 here. And 0 to 1 transition will not going to trigger on the third and fourth flip-flops. So it will remain in previous stage. So by applying the next clock pulse here, zero complement will get 1, and this will not going to turn on second, third, fourth flip flops. So which will give the count sequence 4 ones here. So in this manner we may get the ripple counter sequences. This completes the explanation of asynchronous or ripple counter.